Hey, what's up? This is Richard from Blendergrid, and here I have this blend file which uses a texture. So I have a plane with this this little JPEG file on top of it, and say I want to save this and render it with Blendergrid, then if I just upload only the blend file by dragging it in. And I already did this before, so I'll just remove that real quick. If I just upload the blend file, it's not going to work. And we see that with this little warning section here. The warning says we have a missing image called the JPEG, this one. And that is because I only uploaded the blend file. So how do you solve this? Well, there's two ways you can do this. The most reliable way is to take your blend file, and here I have a .blend1, and I don't really need that because that's like a backup. So you take your blend file and you take your JPEG, select them both, and then you compress them into a zip file. And with Mac, this is the way you do it. With Windows, it's pretty easy as well. And then we get this archive.zip. And if I upload that as a whole, we get our blue plastic project. And it's gonna check it. And now we see we don't have any warnings. So if you look at this one, we get warnings. And this one will render fine. So what happens if you ignore this warning and render it? You'll just see this plane show up as pink. That's what happens. So you don't want that. Let's remove these. And now the second way you can do this is by packing the JPEG file into the blend file. And the reason this is a little bit less reliable is because it only works for simple textures like a single JPEG or a single PNG file, just a single image. If you have an image sequence, this will not work. Or if you have a movie texture, this will not work. And that's just a limitation of Blender at the moment. So I do want to show you this anyway, because this this prevents you from having to create zip files. So it might be a little bit easier in some cases. So if you take a quick look at the blend file, it's 600 kilobytes right now. And now I'm gonna just pack this JPEG into the blend file. The way you do that is go to File, External Data, Pack All into Blend. And what this will do is it will check all the external files that the blend file is importing, and it will pack it into the blend file. So now we have a blend file that is that has everything inside of it. So if you take a look now, and of course I have to save it. So I saved it. We check now, it's 5 megabytes instead of 600 kilobytes. So it's a lot bigger, and that's because this JPEG is now inside of the blend file. So now when we upload just the blend file, and it takes slightly longer to upload this, and we let Blendergrid check the scene, then we see we don't have any warnings and everything will work because we put the JPEG into the blend file. So that is how you use external textures with Blendergrid. You either create a zip file including everything, or you pack the texture into the blend file.